Free to Iowa City. Welcome to a special Doctor Who episode of The Smartest Iron. I'm your Time Lord of the Week, Calvin Gidlaxon, live inside the TARDIS. Tonight, we have two teams competing for the now even more greatest title in Alderland. Starting with you, Team One. Tell us about yourselves.
My name's Greg Chapman, and I've been a on and off again fan of Doctor Who since it's shown up on public television here in Iowa.
And I'm David Bush, and it's the same thing. I've been a Doctor Who fan for about 30 years now, starting on public television and with the new show, too.
Now, Team Two, it's your turn to introduce yourselves.
Folks at home, Iowa City, internet watchers all over the world, you're in for a treat tonight because 2-0 champion, never defeated, Alstro Jr., the smartest Iowan, is back once again. Woo!
He has left.
Yeah. All right.
You're going down, Al.
Yep. And sadly, you are.
I'm here to defend the honor of UNIT, the Universal Network of Iowan Time Lords, of which I have been a proud member since 1999, upon its formation, I believe.
Which I founded.
Which this man to my immediate left founded, my good friend for over 10 years, and my brigade leader, and also the head of my order. Brigade Leader Bill.
Yes, my name is Bill Albert, author, producer, longtime Doctor Who fan since it started in 1973. Mm-hmm. Yes, I can remember it from that long ago.
There you
All
go.
Yours.
Mm-hmm. Okay, the rules are simple enough for even Joe Grant to understand. I will ask you some questions and you give me some answers. Correct answers in round one and two are worth 10 points each, while correct answers in the Iowa round are worth 20 points each. Points are cool. Are you ready? Then let's go. Alonzi! All right, Team One. Who is the very first doctor to play the Doctor?
William Hartnell.
Correct. Who is the current actor to play the Doctor?
Matt Smith.
Correct. Okay. This might be hard for you. What does TARDIS stand for?
Time and Relative Dimension in Space.
That's correct. Due to a malfunction in the TARDIS, is permanently stuck looking like what?
Police box.
Yep, right there.
Yeah.
All right, since Doctor Who was originally planned to be a children's series, what 2007 spinoff decided to go for even more kid-friendly aesthetic?
That would be the Sarah Jane Adventures.
That is correct. What more adult-oriented 2006 spin-off got its name from an anagram of Doctor Who?
That would be Torchwood.
Yes, sir.
Torchwood.
All right. What twin planet of Earth is home to the Cybermen?
Mondas.
That is correct. What other race of the Doctor's foes has been at war with a routine host for more than 50 millennia?
Sontaran.
Yep.
Yeah.
We can accept Sontaran, right?
Mm-hmm. Because they're clones. They're all the same guy.
They're all the same guy.
You know what I mean? You could say Sontaran because, you know, they're all the same. By the way, I'd just like to call you for a minute to say that I'm a fan of classic Doctor Who, as they force me to call it now. Not Doctor Who babies. That's my editorial.
All right.
Well, but no. Billy's the expert on that one, so we got it covered.
All right.
I watch him.
And how many serials did the Foot Doctor fight his Time Lord rival, the Master?
How many?
Yeah.
I'm gonna say. Sorry, which Doctor?
The Fourth.
The Fourth Doctor. Three serials.
Correct. Just to have fun, what are the serial names?
The serials would be The Deadly Assassin, The Keeper of Trakan, and Logopolis.
That's good.
All right. And how many serials did the second Doctor fight his mutant arch nemesis, the Daleks?
How many serials? Okay.
Oh boy, that's gonna be a tough one.
Power of the Daleks.
Power of the Daleks. Evil of the Daleks.
Is that just it?
No. Just more. There's got to be a third one.
What about the War Games for the Daleks?
No, Daleks weren't in War Games. Power of the Daleks. Evil of the Daleks.
There's got to be one we're forgetting.
I think there's three.
Oh no, what's the one where? Yeah, that's the one. No, the one where he goes back. Is there three?
I think there should be a third, considering how many.
Are they going to count the? No, that's the Siren Man.
Mm-hmm. Let's go with three.
We'll go with three.
Yeah. Incorrect. It was two.
Oh,
it was
two. Oh, Power of the Daleks.
No. Yeah, Power of the Daleks and the Evil of the Daleks.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Oh.
Power of the Daleks.
We're pulling ahead. You're going down.
I couldn't think of another one because there wasn't.
There was no other one.
We got to trust our heart.
We outsmarted.
That was a trick question.
Throw me off my game, Billy.
All right.
All right, let's speed it up, everybody.
Name two of the three creators of Doctor Who. All right.
Two of the three creators. Sidney Newman and Verity Lambert.
We don't accept Verity Lambert. It's, right. You got Sidney Newman, correct?
Can I throw another one in?
Yeah.
Let's say.
No. I don't think you can do it again.
David Whittaker?
I'd like a judgment
on that. No. I don't think so. Yeah. How about you, Greg?
I just played BBC. That's all I can say.
Greg was playing D&D earlier. We just got him out of the basement.
What's that bright?
Do you want to know
the Gregory.
Yeah, I can't think of another one.
Okay, let's move on.
Sidney Newman, C.E. Webber, and Donald Wiz Wilson.
We didn't know that one.
All right, name five of the eight actors who played the Master, or portrayed the Master.
Five of the eight?
Five. Yeah.
Okay, we got Eric Roberts.
Roger Delgado.
Of course, the Master. The
Jeffrey
real,
Beavers.
Uh-huh. Anthony Ainslie. How many is that? That's four. Isn't it?
So that's four. We need a fifth one.
Who's the new one?
Oh, you call it, including the new series? John Sims.
Okay, that's five.
Yes. There are also Peter Pratt.
Peter Pratt.
Red and Temple, for no apparent reason there. Mm-hmm. And Derek Jacobi were the other ones.
For you guys at home, Peter Pratt played the Master in one episode and he wore a mask over his face.
Yep.
So.
All right. What two-parter.
In the 70s.
What two-parter featuring a London costume party was the last of the original series to be considered pure historical?
That would be Black Orchid.
That is correct.
Nice. Mm-hmm.
What other two-parter, the first two-parter, in fact, is considered a bottle episode because it took place solely inside the TARDIS?
Edge of Destruction.
Edge of Destruction.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Early on, First Doctor.
Mm-hmm.
Great one.
In the first episode, Bad Wolf, Rose Tyler ends up on a futuristic and dangerous version of what real-life snarktastic game show?
The Weakest Link.
That is correct. In the same episode, Captain Jack Harkness found himself on a version of what makeover show that now stars naked robots, which he hits on?
You got it, Billy?
Oh. Yeah, hit me on that one.
Come on, Bill.
I don't know.
Come on, man. What is it like? Make my day, make my face.
Make my day.
We're all right.
That is
I'm okay,
incorrect.
You're okay. No?
It is
What Not to Wear.
Oh, What Not to Wear.
I love that show.
What actor went uncredited for his role as Black in the episode Vincent and the Doctor?
Bill Nighy.
Correct.
Okay.
All right. What reality TV wife, mom, and judge made a cameo in the episode The Sound of Drums?
Oh boy. These are tough ones.
Mom and judge.
Reality TV wife.
This is Doctor Who the Vampire Slayer, man. This is the fake Doctor Who, man. Give me like the Pertwee questions from 72. That's what I need. 72, 73. Okay. I'm going to say Susan Plumpkin.
Nope. It's Sharon Osbourne.
Oh, Sharon Osbourne. See, this is why I don't like new Doctor Who.
Oh, wait.
That says it all right there.
The last pair of questions are mashups where the last word of each one title becomes the first of another. For example, if you were to combine M. Night Shyamalan's first film with Jane Austen's first novel, you would get The Sixth Sense and Sensibility. So, if you were to combine the episodes where the Doctor and UNIT battle robotic replicas of themselves and misplaced Jurassic denizens, what new super episode would you get?
The Android Invasion of the Dinosaurs?
Correct.
Oh, wow. Oh. Okay, now we're up to the next level. Okay, this is scary. All right.
If you put together the episodes where the Ice Warriors use a deadly fungus of their nefarious plot and War to Fight Over Perennium takes place on Exelon, what would this double serial be called?
Okay. That's, there's two of them, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah, Seeds of Death and Seeds of Doom. Mm-hmm. Seeds of Doom, right? That's what it is, right? Where a flight of Perennium takes place on Exelon, that's gotta be a new one.
That's gotta be one of the Peladon.
No, because it's got to start with Doom.
Seeds of Death to the Daleks.
Correct!
Seeds of Death to the Daleks.
There you
go. Yes!
Yeah.
Seeds of Death to the Daleks.
I wanted to point that...
Hey, Billy, come out.
I wanted to point that...
For God's sake.
The Ice Warriors and the Daleks fight, and the Doctor just has a picnic somewhere. All right, then. Yeah. That takes care of round one. If any of you Whovians out there are watching, this is your chance to get involved. Call us at 319-338-8456 if you know the correct answer to this question. Which Doctor was known for wearing a suit with a whole bunch of question marks on it, including on the handle of his umbrella? And we'll be right back to the Smart Assignment on PATV Channel 18, Iowa City. Teams, pick up your sonic screwdrivers, your markers, and get ready for round two.
You got it.
The actress of which Doctor Who companion married the actor of the third Doctor, John Pertwee? A. Joe Grant, B. Sarah Kingdom, or C. Captain Jack Harkness? And show off your questions. And you put B, Sarah Kingdom, and B. And it is B. Mm-hmm. She was played by G-Moss.
Yeah, she was also the bad guy in Willow.
The writer of episodes including City of Death and the Unproduced Sada also wrote which of these book series? A, Discworld, B, The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, or C, Xanath. Xanth. And so off your...
stuff.
And B and B. And you're correct. It's B. The writer is, of course, Douglas
Adams.
All right. Ninth Doctor Christopher Eccleston played a recurring character on the NBC series Heroes, whose special power was what? A. Invisibility, B. Telekinesis, or C. Time travel? And put it up. You said A and you said B, and team one gets A. Invisibility. Okay. Which season of the original Doctor Who series was this Goth Pattern Quest used? A, season 12, B, season 14, or C, season 16? Mm-hmm. So show yourselves. You put both said A. It was C, season 16. Okay, which of these actresses who played one of the Doctor's companions is singing this UK number one song from 1998? Alright, was it A, Billy Piper, B, Catherine Tate, or C, Kylie Minogue? It was A, Billy Piper.
Al, your plane's going into a death spiral.
The song was Because We Want To.
Oh, like real Doctor Who. Not Doctor Who babies.
Alright, one day before the airing of the very first Doctor Who episode in the United Kingdom, what major historical event occurred in the United States? And now show off your answers. Assassinated JFK, and that is correct. Spell the following villain's name: Gustav Lytton.
It's my understanding there was to be no spelling questions.
And solve your questions. You put Team 1 said G-U-S-T-A-V-L-E-T-T-I-N. They said G-U-S-T-A-V-L-A-Y-T-T-O-N-N. And it's not. It's G-O-S-T-A-V-E-L-Y-T-T-O-N.
Well, that clears that.
They were almost right, but they don't get it still.
If there's one question that I won't remember tomorrow and won't care if I don't remember tomorrow,
what was it? See, Greg, that's just the wrong attitude to
have. All right. Draw a jelly bit, baby. And solar them off, and you've got some guy with a smiley face. Yeah. You also did it, but you look like a gingerbread man. And let's see it. Do they get it?
Yeah, I think we got it.
I think we got it.
Judge?
Yay.
Okay. They both get it. All right, here is the winner's question.
Hi, I'm Christian. I'm last week's winner of the Smartest Iowan, and here's your winner's question. What liquid commodity is sold for less than water in Germany? It is life essential.
So it's, what liquid commodity is sold for less than water in Germany?
Did you say life essential?
No, liquid commodity.
Now let's put it.
Solve your answers. You said milk, and you said beer, and it is beer.
Yeah.
Team 2 gets it.
Yeah.
All right.
It's Germany. Hey, it's got to be beer.
Here is the. Okay. This scene here stars a pre-Dr. David Tennant. Oh. Let's take a look.
Okay.
Barty Crouch, Jr. I'll show you mine if you show me yours.
Your arm hurts.
You know what this means, don't you? He's back. Lord Voldemort has returned.
What is the film?
I tell ya, Harry Potter needs to go to the barber. See that one and that one?
Yeah. And now all solid.
Episode or what?
Tom of Chambers, Sleepy Chambers, see Tom.
We
all right,
need
let's
to.
Let's do it. Let's do it.
Can you?
I'll be really smart.
Okay, and.
Come on now.
Now, and. And it's, yeah. You said Harry Potter and the Prisoner of Azkaban. You said Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire.
That's my
it's
answer.
Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire.
Booyah!
Yeah, exactly.
That's all for round two. We will be right back for the smartest Iron Man.
Really sad part is another cut.
We will be back for the Iron Round after we spent a few years fighting aliens somewhere. Yeah. Well, that was surprisingly uneventful decade, but now we have returned to May 2nd, 2012 in Iowa City for the ever popular Iowa Round.
Yeah.
Of the smartest Iowan. Are you ready?
We're ready.
Ready.
Then let's go! Geronimo! Has an episode of Doctor Who ever been set in Iowa, if only for a second or two?
No.
That's correct. One of Iowa's border states has least received a mention on Doctor Who, when the master claims to have carved himself into Mount Rushmore. Which state is this?
What is South Dakota?
Correct. What Iowa county says its name with the recurring character from the original series played by John Levine?
Benton, Iowa.
That is correct.
Where's you been?
What Iowa county says its name with the companion from the revival series played by Freema Agyeman?
Oh, what was her name?
Oh,
the doctor companion.
Mm-hmm.
You know.
You don't know enough of
my
new.
I blanked out on that one.
I just like to say I check my text. And I like to. Give a shout out to all my fans from around the world. Thanks for it. They're watching the show.
Okay.
I love you.
Should I give it away?
What's her name? Isis or something like that. Or Aegeus.
I'm gonna kill
her. Her name is Amanda. It's like an A.
It's Jones.
Martha Jones.
Margaret Jones.
Martha.
Oh,
okay, what television network frequently hosts marathons and other special Doctor Who events during its annual fundraising festival?
That would be PBS?
Yeah,
can you make it?
Iowa Public Television.
What?
Iowa Public Television.
That's correct.
Yes.
For the first time since the revival of Doctor Who, IPTV's Festival 2012 failed to show what type of episode, replacing it with a Life on Mars episode.
Failed to show what type of episode? A Doctor Who episode?
Yeah.
Or Red Dwarf.
What type of Doctor Who?
Oh, yeah. Classic Doctor Who, which they force us to call us now. It sucks.
It's just a Doctor Who special.
What special type of episode? What special?
Episode. I don't know.
Oh, come on, you're giving them the answer.
Come on. It's the Christmas special.
Oh!
You're failing right now, you guys.
It's again.
I'm usually answering a phone, so I don't.
It's like 6 years for the show.
Okay. Okay. And Doctor Who and the Silurians, the particular villains plot to destroy an outer space phenomenon named after what Iron scientist who discovered it?
Van Allen belt.
Will he give
Van
it?
Allen? The Van Allen radiation belts?
What scientist?
What is the scientist?
James Van Allen.
That's correct. In Daleks in Manhattan, people during the Great Depression live in shanty towns named after what Iowa-born President of the United States.
Hooverville.
That's correct. Herbert Hoover. And now, what Iowa town says its name with the actor who played one of the doctor's first three companions?
Two teachers and Susan, yeah, so. The two teachers
and Susan. That's the
one. Are we looking for the actor's name?
Yeah, one of them.
So played one of them.
City.
Hill?
Do you know?
No.
It's Russell. William Russell?
Russell Iowa.
Who played Ian Chesterton?
Okay.
Right. Mm-hmm. Hey, all right. What Iowa town says its name with the actor who played Sergeant Benton's usual companion?
Sergeant Benton's usual companion was
Yates.
Who played him?
His name of the actor who played Richard Franklin.
Richard Franklin.
So, is there a Franklin, Iowa?
Franklin.
There is.
Really? I did not know there was a Richard, Iowa.
Bell. I didn't know the answer.
The Cloister Bell has won, so the game is over. We will return in just a few seconds. This time to find out who knew their who better. Final scores after the break.
Mm. Well done. Put this t-shirt in half.
You bring out all your friends.
They can wear them together at family reunions.
I've known I was the smartest guy I went for quite a while. It's
Team
really
one.
Nice to prove it on
took
television.
Took it. These scatterbrains. 140 points. McKeith and Darius. They will be winning, of course, these beautiful t-shirts. Congratulations, Cyprian. Sorry, Tyler. It was a very close match. I'm very impressed, you guys.
If you
go,
let's tally the score. Nah. Team 1 is 230, and Team 2 is 190.
I've won twice in a row. There's one thing different here. Yeah, that's what's different this time. All right, that's all I got to say. All right, that's like when I'm on my own.
You guys,
that's all
Team
I gotta
1,
say.
You are the smartest humans. How does it feel to win?
I'm sure Mark up
it feels fantastic.
I'm
going to officially file a protest.
How does it feel to lose?
No, because I don't even think I was misrepresented. I thought this was a Dr. Who show, not a Dr. Who babies.
All right.
You should have said it's going to be
thank you for watching the smartest timing. I don't want to go, but we have to. A big thank you to our sponsors, Graphic Printing and Design in Texas Roadhouse.
Sexy Dr. Who.
Also, a big thanks to the PBC for giving us the greatest TV show ever. If you would like to be a contestant on the Smartest Simon, email us at smartestsimon@gmail.com. On behalf of PATV, I'm telling good luck to cheerio.
All right, listen, I give it up to you. I may want to.
It was a good day.
I blame myself.
If you'd like to complain about...
I don't blame Bill either. I blame myself.
If you'd like to talk to Al about his ego, call 1-800...
No, it's not my ego. I'm defending Classic Doctor Who. I'm sticking up for Classic Doctor Who.
1-800...
Did you not just witness how Doctor Who was... Classic Doctor Who was railroaded in this show. It was railroaded. Not even one third Doctor question. That says it all. Not even one third Doctor.
We did the combination once. We did the combination.
This is why they lost. They can't agree on
that show.
We got Richard Franklin.
Not even one question about
it. If this thing walks, it would ignore it or something.
I don't think Franklin was even ever answered. We'll be right back.